was all serious about the music. I hadn't seen Dodge for a few months. We met in a record shop and we just started to just tell each other what we're up to. And at the same time as I was getting into, you know, sampling and stuff like that, he was on a computer course, you know, learn the basics of studio engineering. So, you know, both the same interests really, so, you know, took it from there.
Natural thing to hook up. Basically, we had a couple of demos on cassette, and through like friends of ours, we kind of got management, because our management team are also friends from back in the day, and they had our tape, and there was a vibe going around with a couple of other groups at the time, and our demo was like one of the hot demos that was knocking around, and you know, we got a couple of offers, one of which ended up being Fall From Broadway. Worked out, you know, a few months of negotiations and that's it. I wouldn't say it was difficult. You know, I'd say we were very lucky because like getting a deal is not an easy thing. Right time,
right
place.
Because the music was Crazy Fat Fly, actually.
Yeah, we could say that. It doesn't make any difference whether you spend 8 years trying to find a deal or whether you spend 8 weeks trying to find a deal and get a deal. See what I mean?
The basic thing is to get your music out there.
That's it.
You know, and we chose the path of, you know, doing it in a studio, producing it in the studio, then take it out, you know. And other things came with it, like the live part of it. We decided, yeah, this stuff can go live. So we got a band together and, you know, we're going live. And that's a new experience, but, you know, paying the dues, we're paying the dues. Yeah, we are paying the dues, but, you know, we're paying it to, you know, people who influenced us musically. You know
there,
I mean?
There are millions of people out there who make music every day, and they're waiting for this, and they're waiting for that, and they're waiting for the other. I say to them, why don't you get some money together, put out a record, whatever. You know, before we got a deal, we had a solid plan. We're going to do a demo, we're going to fund it ourselves, we're going to go to a pressing plant, and we're going to put out a record. So if we hadn't signed to Island, you know, we would have had a record out, because it's all about putting out records. It's all about putting out your music. It's not about messing around at home for God knows how many years and having loads of great tracks that nobody's ever going to hear. And that's the way we work today as well, you know. It's all about output.
Well, Dodge Seat Productions, you know, under that umbrella can come a lot of things. A live aspect of the music. We're artists as well. We rap, we write, we produce our music. So therefore, you know, Dodge Seat Productions keeps the middleman out. We run our things, we control our business, and we're telling everyone we run things.
And that's from the start as well. That's not like a new thing, because obviously now this is a couple of years after we came out with a debut. So people probably think, you know, it's not no new thing. If people dig back and they read an interview from Dodge City 1991, they'll know that Dodge City Productions came out as a unit, as a, you know, a group thing which incorporates, you know, rap, song, dance, showmanship, entertainment, everything. You know, we're gonna remixes, you know, which we've proven we can do. It's just a matter of, you know, pumping
well,
it more.
Some people have said to me, well, we thought Dodge City was more than two, but, you know, it's not, it's just two people with the same interest, just taking it all on board. What gratifies us the most? What gratifies me is like sitting here talking about how we got this thing together, because sometimes it doesn't happen. Some people, you know, just fall by the wayside, but we're still in there kind of doing it and talking to people about it because people are interested. So, you know, this is the buzz I get off it. You know, the work, we just do the work, you know what I mean, because that's what we're into, you know.
Performing's nice too. Live, that's nice, because we've done a few live gigs lately and we've got a load coming up, so that's real nice. You know, because then you see people in front of you, get instant reaction to what you're dealing with. It's not like being in a studio locked away when you're on your own vibe and, you know. We're two Londoners, you know, kind of born around the way, grew up in London, mainly in the club scene, which for the best part has been like really multicultural. You've had like reggae scene with the sound systems. IG knows more about that than me because he's, you know, he used to chat sound them. Then you had the soul scene with like, you know, the funk, the soul. Then you had kind of like the jazz scene, you know, everything is here. And at some stage or another, we've passed through it. Therefore, we're into many styles of music. Therefore, making music has to incorporate many sounds, many styles.
You know, it's time now to kind of break the rules, basically. I mean, certain rules have been made by certain, you know, powers. You know, music's supposed to be that way, or music is supposed to sound that way. You know, we've worked with certain musicians who said that it's wrong. You know, but if it sounds right to the ear, then it's got to be right to your ear. You know, and if other people get into it, then it's got to be right, I suppose. You know, so.
Yeah, we've been talking about this thing between us for a long time about, you know, it's not a matter of, you know, Dodge City getting into all these different people's homes. It's a matter of them taking the time to listen to what we're dealing with and then getting into us and understanding it.
Yeah, I mean,
it's not that complicated.
We're not musicians. Mm. You know, we just use our ear, basically. And we think we know what sounds good to us, you know? So if I think a certain bass line sounds good, you know, I would ask a bass player to play it. And if he thinks it's wrong, I don't give it a damn kind of thing. Just play it the way we want it to sound.
Thousand.